In the field of extragalactic astronomy, the launch of the James Webb Space Telescope heralded the beginning of a new era. The infrared observatory has only been operational for a few weeks, but it has already uncovered several candidate galaxies that call into question both the Big Bang theory and our galactic evolution models. And at this point, Webb's instruments were trained on Earendel, the most isolated and remote star that has ever been discovered in the universe. Hey guys, welcome back to the Future Space. In today's video, we are going to discover the farthest star that has ever been discovered, so stay with us till the end of this video so you don't miss out on any of this information. The distance from Earth to Earendel, measured in light years, is 12.9 billion. This indicates that the star existed in the universe when it was only 900 million years old, if the theory of the Big Bang is correct. Over the course of the past half century, astronomers have been on the lookout for a unique population of stars similar to Earendel. But how did researchers manage to locate a solitary star in such a remote part of the cosmos? What makes Earendel stand out from the other stars that we can see in the night sky? Lastly, and most importantly, in what ways did the recent observations that James Webb made of Earendel challenge our theories regarding the evolution of stars? The distance to Earendel as measured by light travel is 12.9 billion light years, but the distance as measured by the present proper distance, which takes into account the expansion of the universe, is 28 billion light years. Therefore, we are seeing the star exactly as it appeared 12.9 billion years ago when we look at it. As a result, Earendel has been around for approximately 8.2 billion years longer than both the Sun and the Earth. At these great distances, the smallest objects that have been seen so far are star clusters that are embedded in more distant galaxies. Earendel, on the other hand, is the first isolated star to be discovered at such a great distance. Using the Hubble Space Telescope, astronomers made an accidental discovery of this star. The star's parent galaxy, which was being gravitationally distorted by a cluster in the foreground, was the first object that Hubble observed. Massive astronomical objects, such as clusters of galaxies, can warp the fabric of space and time as they pass through it. When it travels close to these enormous objects, the light coming from the celestial bodies in the foreground is warped because of the distortion caused by these objects. When the conditions are just right, the light coming from individual stars can be magnified by the foreground clusters by a factor of thousands in certain circumstances. As a result of the gravitational lensing, the background galaxy that contained Earendel appeared to be in the shape of an arc, which the astronomers refer to as the Sunrise Arc. The group, however, noticed a brilliant object that was perched on the edge of the warped galaxy. Luminous sources in distant galaxies are typically highly energizing events such as novas, supernovas, or tidal disruptions caused by black holes. These types of events can also produce light. These are transients whose brightness is varying naturally over the course of the observation. Nevertheless, the observations made by Hubble over a period of more than 3.5 years revealed that the brightness of this object had not changed. Astronomers came to the conclusion that it is a bright star in the Sunrise Arc that has been gravitationally magnified. Due to the limitations of its wavelength, the Hubble Space Telescope was only able to provide limited information about this faraway star. Therefore, astronomers made use of the James Webb Space Telescope to conduct further research on Earendel's properties. Dr. Brian Welsh from Johns Hopkins University served as the study's primary investigator. Using data from the Hubble Space Telescope, he and his team made the discovery of a star in March of 2022. The researchers analyzed new images of Earendel that were obtained by the NERTCam instrument on Webb's spacecraft in their published work. The wavelengths represented in these images ranged from 0.8 to 5 microns. The planet Earendel was observed during a total of 8 distinct Webb filters, and the exposure time for each filter was greater than half an hour. In light of the recent observations made by the JWST, there are 3 key points that should be brought to your attention. The first factor to consider is the redshift of the star. The redshift of objects in deep space provides a measurement of their distance. A dimensionless quantity known as z is used to denote redshift. Z equals 0 denotes the current time, and as its value increases, both the look-back time and the distance to that object also increase. The redshift of 6.2 that Earendel possesses has been verified by recent observations from Webb. According to the findings of the Hubble Space Telescope, which were made public in the beginning of 2022, Earendel has the highest redshift of any star ever discovered. The next significant aspect of Earendel to take into account is its bolometric luminosity, which can be defined as the total amount of energy that the star emits across the electromagnetic spectrum. Based on the data collected by Webb, it can no longer be assumed that Earendel is either a low-mass star a brown dwarf star, or a free-floating exoplanet that was gravitationally lensed. Instead, the evidence suggests that it is a star of the B-type, and its effective surface temperature ranges from 13 to 16,000 Kelvin. The surface temperatures of stars in the universe are the primary factor that determines which categories they fall into. These categories are O, B, A, F, G, and M. Oh, be such a good girl, kiss me is a time-tested mnemonic device that can be used to remember the sequence. When we attempt to calculate the total luminosity of Earendel, which is somewhere between 600,000 and 1 million times the luminosity of the Sun, we run into a problem. If this is the case, then Earendel must have a mass approximately 40 times greater than that of the Sun if it is a single evolved star. If one assumes a surface temperature of approximately 15,000 Kelvins, then this light could also be produced by two stars with 30 solar masses or five stars with 20 solar masses. In their research paper, the researchers point out that an explanation based on a single star is not the only possible explanation for the spectral energy distribution plots. Because of this, one cannot dismiss the idea that Earendel is actually a system consisting of more than one star. The most massive stars in our neighborhood of the universe almost always have companions, and in many cases they have multiple companions. The distance between a star and its tertiary companions can be as great as 20 astronomical units, whereas the primary companions are always within 2 astronomical units of the star. This indicates that even if Earendel is accompanied by other stars, those stars will not be visible to the James Webb telescope due to the high-resolution power of the instrument. Another issue is that the star will go beyond the Humphreys-Davidson limit, also known as the HD limit, if it has a luminosity that is 1 million times greater than that of the Sun. The HD limit is the empirical luminosity limit that, at least in our part of the universe, has not been exceeded by any stars that have been observed. Therefore, if it turns out that Earendel is a single star with a luminosity 1 million times greater than that of the Sun, we might have to rethink the HD limit and put some new constraints on it. It's possible that this is the first observation of a Population 3 star, which astronomers have been looking for decades. Therefore, Earendel's discovery is significant for that reason. Hydrogen and helium were the first two major chemical elements to be produced by the process of primordial nucleosynthesis. The magnitude of Earendel's magnificence is forecast to remain high for many years to come, according to astronomers. It is anticipated that the JWST will make its subsequent observation of Earendel in December 2022. If the brightness of Earendel and its surface temperature could be accurately measured, we could get a better idea of the type of star it is and where it is in its life cycle. In addition, astronomers anticipate discovering that the Sunrise Arc galaxy is devoid of the heavy elements that are produced by succeeding generations of stars. And that's for today's video. We sincerely hope you enjoyed the video. If so, give it a like and share it with your friends and family. Let us know if you have any questions or comments in the section below. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to see more of our incredible videos. You can also watch our other videos that have been specially selected for you. Look forward to seeing you in the next video.